800 years ago, Calder and his friends work as witch hunters to find the witch who cursed the town with a black death that killed dozens of families. When they reach the middle of the forest, they discover that the witch queen was behind this and she summons a swarm through her mouth to kill the first soldier. She then spawns some undead to attack her, and Calder quickly ignites her sword to keep them at bay. A fierce battle ensues, and as his friends battle evil creatures, Calder goes in search of the queen and finds a toy on the ground that reminds her of her deceased family. Calder realizes this is not real, and begins fighting the witch queen directly upon breaking the illusion. The queen pushes him into a tree hole and traps him with roots, but Calder rekindles his sword and starts a large fire. He then attempts to stab her queen to death, but when she dies, the queen casts a curse of immortality on Calder, and he must live forever in tormented solitude. Calder still lives as a witch hunter. He is now on a plane, and as he breathes into the window, he sees a symbol indicating the presence of magic. Calder finds the witch by attaching a needle to a glass of water as a compass and kills the person next to her by pouring water over her lap. It turns out that the witch was traveling with an ancient rune in her bag, causing a storm that soon crashed her plane. In fact, the plane suddenly began to shake, but Calder grabbed the runes and disabled them, and the storm instantly dissipated. Sometime later, Calder visits his dear friend Duran the 36th, who also works for the Axe and Cross organization. It turns out that the witch still exists and she is allowed to coexist with humans as long as she doesn't use magic. Calder only intervenes when necessary to keep the peace. Mr. Dolan will be retiring soon after 50 years of service, and Mr. Calder is giving him an antique pen as a memento. He also learns that his friends have already chosen Dolan the 37th, a young man who vows to care for Calder. After that, the 36th Duran takes a taxi home while the mysterious Belial watches from afar. The next day, Calder receives a phone call informing him that Dolan the 36th died in his sleep last night. Devastated by the news, Calder watches a ceremony in which a young man with burns on his arm is officially declared the 37th Dolan. The two then go to the dead Duran's apartment to investigate the death. Calder uses his usual tricks to look for elemental magic such as window breath and lighter, but there are no signs. However, when he was about to leave, he found the dead bodies of three bugs and became suspicious. He uses a special powder on the floor and pulls out a pentagram that suddenly explodes and causes runes to appear on the wall. This confirms that the entire room was cursed with a rare black magic that killed his friend. Upon closer inspection, Calder found that the pen was missing. He also finds a book with blood fingerprints on it and begins to suspect the new Dolan, but the man exposes his burned hand to prove his innocence. When he was a child, some witches set his house on fire, and it was Calder who saved him from it. The two then head to a local bakery to break into the kitchen and cook some creepy ingredients. The powerful witch Max sells illegal pieces there, hears the sound and tries to escape with a swarm of butterflies, but Calder catches them in a bottle and prevents them from going. Max says she doesn't know anything about dark magic users. But when Calder insists in her threatening tone, Max says she's selling forbidden herbs to a man she doesn't know. She explains. Max can't describe the man because he's blind, but he smelled arsenic and rotten apples coming from his body. This leads Calder to suspect that the culprit is at a funeral parlor near the apple tree, so he sends Dolan home for safety and sets off alone to find the killer. Meanwhile, the child is shocked to find tracks of gummies on the road and, following them, finds a beautiful gummies tree near the bright house that Belial is looking at. As the boy grabs the gummy bear, Calder stops him, revealing it is actually a rotten apple. The house is dilapidated and ugly, and when Calder comes to investigate, he finds a young girl frightened. Calder approaches her and realizes she is a wizard in disguise named Eric. Warlock attempts to attack Calder, stabs her hand and escapes. Calder's wounds soon closed, and he lunged at Ellis, throwing his knife into the wall. Finding a pen as a gift from Dolan, Calder stuns Eric and takes him to the witch council, where the 37th witch gets the chance to beat Eric in revenge. Council leader Glazer uses map reading to prove Eric guilty, but she hears Calder say she couldn't act alone given the powerful spells Eric used. Ignore. Glazer summons a terrifying creature called a sentinel and feeds Eric without hesitation. Calder then notices a dead bug on Glazer's clothes and gives him an idea. He examined the body of Duran the 36th and used a carved candle to prove the existence of magic. He then searches Doran's throat to find another insect, proving that he was not dead, but was in fact cursed by old-fashioned black magic. The only way to remove the curse is to kill the sorcerer who cast it. Eric's death proves that he worked for someone. Calder also notices a cut on Dolan's finger and double-checks the book. In doing so, Calder discovered several bloody fingerprints left intentionally to form the message "Remember Death." Calder no longer remembers his childhood, so he turns to the witch's tavern for help. Calder's mere presence deters all witches except Chloe, the owner. Chloe asks Calder for a talisman of her memory. Chloe is reluctant to help because her witch hunters are hunting the same race as her, but she agrees, explaining that Calder is for her friends. She stuffs a cherry with a memory potion, and when Calder eats it, she suddenly finds herself lost in a haunted forest and finds her charred corpse kneeling on the ground. But just when you want to see more, Belial appears and breaks his spell. Calder suddenly found himself chained to the ground. By breaking his finger, he managed to get through his handcuffs and free himself before starting a fight with Belial in pursuit. Unfortunately, Calder is still under the spell's influence and is constantly plagued with hallucinations, which prevents him from fighting well. Belial takes the chance to set the bar on fire, leaving Chloe to pull Calder out of his trance. Calder thinks she is her queen and tries to kill her, but she sprays powder in his face and wakes him up just in the nick of time. Calder tries to catch Belial again, but Belial burrows a root hole into the ground and disappears. Chloe tries to use the fire extinguisher in vain and laments that the bar is gone. Because she's the only one she has. Calder is a monster, he says, as everyone says. Later that night, Chloe hears strange noises in her apartment, and suddenly all the lights explode, causing roots to open another hole in the ground, dragging Chloe into hell. Chloe tries to escape her control and finds Calder's hand helping her, but just then she wakes up to find herself in the cathedral. Calder and the 37th Duran investigate Belial, and Calder enlists Chloe's help again to persuade her to work with him to get revenge on Bar. Chloe accepts, but needs ingredients for a potion because the bar is gone, and she takes Calder to her friend's house. When they arrive there, Chloe is shocked to learn that her friend has been murdered and all her precious plants have been stolen. At that time, her friend's cell phone receives a phone call, warning of further attacks from Belial. With no other choice, Calder seeks out the dangerous witch Danique. Danique agrees to lend her plants. But while Chloe is preoccupied with observing plants, Calder suddenly begins to see fantasies about his family. Danique turns out to be her traitor, and while her allies capture Chloe, Calder falls under the spell of her memory. He looks forward to being reunited with his family, but his happiness is interrupted by Chloe, who keeps talking and pushing until he wakes up. Back in reality, Calder is dragged away by Danique's minions. He quickly knocks everyone out, finds and frees Chloe, and then interrogates Danique. The witch is unaware of Belial's intentions, and she swears that she only got the plants Belial needed. Calder decides to leave without punishing her, but Chloe retaliates by stealing and destroying Danique's magic gem, revealing Danique's true, terrifying face. Calder then has a conversation with Chloe, confirming that she is a dreamwalker, meaning she doesn't need drugs to enter someone's mind. She admits that she is afraid of her abilities because her brother died when Chloe used them on her brother. There, Calder takes her to a sacred place that shows her witchcraft history. After enlightening her about her legacy, he reminds her that he cannot die and guides her through the process of looking into her own heart. The two revisit Curse Night and discover the charred corpse of Calder, who roared as his friends approached. Calder began screaming in pain as the first Duran attempted to destroy the queen's heart. This meant that he could not kill the queen without killing Calder. Although her heart was hidden, Chloe realizes that Belial murdered Dolan the 36th was her heart, and she intended to use it to bring back her queen. Meanwhile, Belial kidnaps Max and takes him to the old forest, where he places him on a tree to be sacrificed to the witch queen, whom he calls with all his heart. Back in Calder, he goes to the cathedral and yells at Dolan 37th because no one in the organization told him that he hid the heart. The young man replied that Dolan had considered destroying his heart to give Calder his freedom. He also tells Calder the location of Belial's truck, which can be traced. Sometime later, Calder arrives in the woods and discovers that Max is possessed by the witch queen. Chloe suddenly appears behind him, but when Calder is distracted, Belial drops a hallucination and attacks Calder with fire magic, followed by several shots. However, Calder kills him with a quick knife throw. The queen takes advantage of this distraction to stab Calder with a root and regain immortality. She explained that she didn't give them to him, just that he kept them safe until she got her body back. Max loses her form and transforms into her queen and attacks Calder with her enchanted swarm, but she disappears into the trees as Calder responds with gunshots. Calder rushes back to town and discovers that Dolan the 36th has awakened. However, Calder is not satisfied. He knows that her queen is about to cast the Black Death curse on her, and there is nothing he can do to stop her. Duran reminds Calder that he killed the queen once and encourages him to try again. Determined to prove himself to his friends, Calder armed himself with a legendary sword and some runes. He then accompanies Chloe and Dolan the 37th to visit the council chamber where the plague tree is kept from the hands of evil. Grazer was found dead, confirming that the queen had come here to spread the plague. They follow a secret passageway into the cave where the council was holding the arrested witches. Calder breaks through the wall to free Eric's body, and the plague spell is exorcised. When Chloe gets inside Eric's mind, the sentinel appears. Calder and Duran fire, but the bullets do nothing. Calder is blown away, but quickly recovers and jumps onto the sentinel, stabbing it with his sword and hitting its weak point, causing it to explode. Meanwhile, Chloe appears in Eric's mind and tries to stab him, but Eric jumps on her and slams her to the ground, killing her. After some fighting, Chloe manages to fight back, throwing Eric into a root pit and instantly stopping the plague spell from being cast. While Chloe returns to reality, Calder goes in search of the queen, who is creating post-apocalyptic illusions to fight Calder. Calder is now on the verge of death, and a single attack scars him. After a few punches, Calder managed to stab the queen, but this only removed the illusion. Back in reality, Calder uses runes to light his sword and knock out the queen again. But just as he is about to deliver the final blow, Dolan the 37th appears and holds Chloe at gunpoint. He also turns out to be a witch, but he is incapable of using magic and the witches Calder killed as a child were his parents. Duran shoots Calder dead and hands Chloe over to the witch queen, who immediately uses her to begin her chant again, eventually unleashing her plague across her town. Duran hopes to be rewarded with magic, but the queen sees the man without magic as useless and kills him along with her lover. Meanwhile, an unconscious Calder begins to dream of a family that supports him and motivates him to try again. Calder wakes up and uses the plane's weather rune on his sword to activate the lightning effect. He then threw it at her queen, effectively killing her and regaining her immortality. As his wounds heal, the plague disappears from the city. The queen's body crumbles to ashes, but her heart is still beating. Calder doesn't care about his future and tries to stab him, but Chloe stops him by explaining that the world still needs him to keep fighting witches. She also protects her heart and promises that she will never leave him alone again. Sometime later, Calder tells Dolan 36 that he no longer intends to work for the organization, and leaves with Chloe in search of his next adventure. End. Conclusion. In the aftermath of an epic battle against the Witch Queen and her dark forces, Calder emerges victorious but wounded. With the support of Chloe, a fellow dreamwalker, he not only defeats the Witch Queen but also discovers the strength within himself to continue his role as a witch hunter. Together, they embark on a new journey, leaving behind the organization and embracing their destiny to protect the world from the forces of darkness. Thanks again for Movies Recapped. If you enjoyed this movie recap, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more captivating narratives and engaging content. Please also comment on your thoughts and so I know you subscribed and I will reply back to you.